Our goal is to push fields forward, push science forward, push research forward. And this was an opportunity to do that in a very unique way, and in a way that hopefully helps the community. Obviously, in the world that we live in right now, there is a lot of science misinformation, and a lot of that is just a communication flaw. The science is correct, the ideas are correct, the intent is correct, the messaging is not. I watched a webinar that was discussing taking an environmental science paper and turning it into basically a graphic novel, and thought, we have a lot of information on this campus that would disseminate well in that media. I kind of came up with the idea, and I presented the idea to some people just to see if we could get it off the ground, and then it became a team.
I work on comic books and do feature filmmaking on the side. I've done several dozen films over the years. So I've done maybe about 20 or so comic books in the last 8 years, and including this run of CCTS comic books, I think there's about 4,000 to 5,000 comic books I've produced or published in 8 years. I've gone to a lot of the comic book shows, Lexington Comic Con. Sometimes I'm a featured artist and guest at the shows, and I've done the whole circuit. I've been in front of the camera, behind the camera, in front of the pencil, behind the pencil, doing the publishing stuff. So I've just kind of, like a Swiss Army knife, I've just kind of done it all.
So I decided to apply for this CCTS Communication Challenge. When I saw it come out, I thought, I really don't know if this is a good fit for me, but hey, why not? So a lot of my research is on tobacco prevention. And so this particular study focused on college students and their use of e-cigarettes. And we really wanted to understand why they were using, the prevalence, and what were some of the risk factors for those who were deciding to initiate, but then also continue use. And so all of that goes into the comic, which is really exciting to help form the story and the characters.
The goal of the project was twofold. It was to disseminate information to an audience that doesn't follow the scientific literature, and it was also to challenge our investigators to think outside the box on how they disseminate their information. So can we take a manuscript that's been published, and can we turn it into a story?
So the goal of this comic book was to communicate the findings related to the prevalence and use of e-cigarettes. And so this was for a distinct population. This was late high school, early college age population.
One, I would love to use this as an opportunity to talk about research, on a public health issue that's really important in our communities because so many of our young people are using e-cigarettes. I think we can talk about it in a way that relates to people, that makes sense in terms of they can do something about it. But then the other goal is to use this comic book in schools and in prevention programming. So how can we then develop curriculum around the comic? You know, I think it's really fun to talk about the characters and what they're going through and how we can build peer refusal skills, how we can talk about being advocates in their community.
I think probably the most challenging aspect was underestimating what we were getting ourselves into. We started out with some sketches and a very brief storyboard, and it seemed like a couple more meetings and we would have it ready to go. We probably had 25 meetings, probably 30 or 40 rewrites on the script. I don't know how many times Brian went in and edited imagery for us.
So we had to do a little bit of reaching out to this population and really asking them, is this how you would say this to your friends? Does this sound awkward? You tell us how you would say this or how you might come across the information.
How do we narrow down the focus? How do we put in the most important things that really help tell the story, keep the page turning?
So that was just probably the greatest aspect of what just too much scientific stuff, what's maybe too much creativeness, and just finding the right balance between those two worlds. And I think we really pulled it off for this project.
When I saw that first real copy that had the cover and the title page and our names, it just was this, oh my goodness, we've worked really hard to pull this together, and I think people are really gonna like it.
Just working with our team and of producers and artists and writers, we just was able to come together and kind of create a very unique product that we kind of hope will help with addiction, with vaping and smoking. So if one person reads this book and then puts down the comic and then puts down their cigarette, that's a plus one in my book.
It's important that CCTS supports innovative projects like this one because these projects speak to what it means to translate research into something that we can create action for, that we can do something about. If we understand something better, we feel more motivated to take action.
It really helped me see how we can talk about research in a different way, how we can engage young people. if we keep pushing the envelope as the CCTS is helping us do, we're going to reach more people across Kentucky and even beyond.